Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Are you still wondering how to bring in your lower third or full screen Bible on OBS? Don't worry, because I also had the same issue while using OBS till I was able to figure it out. And in this particular video, I'm going to show you how to bring in your scripture in lower third format and also in full screen on OBS. While the preacher is preaching, you can be able to project your scripture on the screen in lower third format and also in full screen, so that those watching can be able to read along as the preacher is reading the scripture. Okay, so, and if you haven't subscribed to this YouTube channel or just coming across this channel for the first time, you're welcome. Also subscribe to this YouTube channel by clicking on that red subscribe button below, and also turn on the notification bell. When you do, you will always be notified whenever I upload new videos. And if you're a returning subscriber, thank you very much for supporting. Also remember to give this video a thumbs up as usual, so the YouTube algorithm can also recommend it to other people as well. Now, without any further ado, let's get straight to this particular video. Okay, the first thing we are going to do is to download Untitled Chapter for OBS. That's the Untitled Chapter plugin for OBS. In order for us to do that, just go over to your browser that you're using on your computer. Going to go click on Chrome, because that's what I want to use, that's my default browser, and search for Obs Ndi plugin. Okay, see that the Obs Ndi plugin, I can see the Untitled Ndi integration into Obs Studio, and you can see whichever link you click, be it the first one, be it the second one, all of them are still the same thing. Okay, so but I'm just going to paste the Google Drive link where I have uploaded everything, both the Untitled Ndi plugin and also Bible Show, which is the software we all be making use of in order for us to display our Bible in lower third format on OBS and also on full screen. Okay, let me just show you that Bible Show, which is the two softwares that we need. Okay, so that is it here. Instead of downloading it from here, I've already compiled everything, both the King James version and other versions, the Arabic version, the French version. I've already compiled everything inside this folder. You can see inside this folder. So all you have to do is click on the link in the description below and download the folder. Okay, so once you download the folder on your laptop, go ahead and unzip it. Let me show you how to do that. Okay, so I'm just going to minimize this and go over to our file explorer. This is it, file explorer, download, and this is it here, OBS Ndi and Bible Show. So this is it right here. So just download that into your computer and you can click and extract here. No password was added to it, so just download and extract it. You can see it here. So once you open it, you get to see all of this here. Now the first one is the Bible Show 5. The second one is the King James version of Bible for the Bible Show, and the second one and the third one is the OBS Ndi plugin for OBS, and the other ones are other versions of Bible that I added, the French and the Arabic versions that I added to it. So you can also install them as well, depending on the country you're watching me from, if you use Arabic Bible or French Bible or rather whichever one. So you can just install any of them that is there. Okay, let's install the Bible Show 5. I'm just going to double click on it, and next you can see next install. That's it. So the Bible Show 5 has finished installing. Now let's also install the King James version. Okay, so which is what we make use of in my church. So let's just double click on it and hit the install button there, and you can see the King James version has finished installing. Now another thing we are going to do is to install the OBS Ndi. Okay, so just double click on the OBS Ndi and let's install it. Okay, so just click on next there. Next, you say okay, already exists, would you like to install to that folder anyway? Yes, just select yes to install it there. Next, and install. Okay, so this will download and install it, the OBS Ndi plugin, to our computer and all these. Okay, oh sorry, just select accept the agreement there, and this is it. You need the Ndi 4 runtime. Okay, so let's also install that as well, which comes along with the OBS Ndi plugin. Okay, so it updates the network setting and everything. So all right, finish. So everything has been successfully installed. Now after you've done this, the next thing I want you to do for me is to restart your PC. Okay, so in order for everything we've installed to show, let's restart our PC, and after that I will show you what else to do. Okay, so let me just go ahead and restart my PC. Double click on it. I'm just going to do that here. Okay, and this is it. Our OBS Studio is up. Now, after you've opened the OBS Studio, another thing I want you to do for me is to open the Bible Show 5. Okay, so just double click on the Bible Show 5. As you can see, the shortcut on my Windows PC there, just right click on it, and just going to give it a moment for it to load. Okay, so expand this, make okay, this is the showing you the Bible Show, blah 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 blah. Let's just close this window, we don't need it. It's just like a summary window. Okay, so this is the the Bible Show interface. You can see it looks a bit complicated, but don't worry, it's really easy to use. You can see this is the Bible version here, the King James version that we just installed. You can see it's working perfectly fine, and these are all some of the Bible scriptures. You can see that these are the chapters. So once you select any of the chapters there, you will see the verse, and you can select any verse you want. After you selected that, click on this red button there. Let me just show you what I'm saying. This red button there, you can see any of this red button here. So just select any of them to display in your scripture. You can see, so I'm just going to select anyone. You see my scripture is up now. This scripture now we are seeing here is on full display. Now how do we convert it to lower third so that it will look a bit moderate and, you know, lower third format, so the people can be able to see this, the preacher and also the scripture all at the same time. Okay, now the first thing you are going to do is go over to Teams. You can see, go over to Teams here and click on download. You can see I'm already on Teams, so click on download. You can see the download button there. Click on the download button there and wait for it to load, and you can see different types of Teams. You can see, so whichever one you like, you can also download. So click on this select package. You can see Team Collection 1 and go over to 6. Yeah, go over to Teams Collection 6. Go over to it and wait for it to load, and you can see all the lower third formats here. You can see all of them here. You can see that's all of them. Just hit the download and install button there to download it and install it. The lower third Teams has already finished downloading and is also installed on our Bible Show. Okay, so let's just look for it. You are going to see it here. You can see it there. That's it right there. You can see that's it. That's it right there. So just select any of them that I want to use and leave it there. Now, how do we configure the Bible Show software to work and also display on OBS? Go over to Configure tab. That's it here. Let me show you. Go over to Configure tab this here. Just click on it. Click on the Configure tab there. Just do that. Click on the Configure tab and select NDI output. Remove it from display windows and set it on NDI. Oh, sorry. So let me just close it. I made a mistake. Okay, so it's asking me to has blocked some features of this app. Just click on allow access. Okay, so just click on allow access and make sure you disable the display windows. Okay, so disable that and leave it on NDI output. Okay, so leave it on NDI output, and this is it here, NDI output. So go back to Teams, and if you want to work on the aspect ratio or whichever one, but I urge you to leave it the way it is. If not, you will alter the display and it will look unorganized. Okay, so just leave it the way it is and go back to Teams. See, go back to Teams and you can select whichever one you want. Now we are making use of this one. Let's try and play another scripture. You can see how it looks like. Everything looks perfect, and we selected the NDI output. Now go over to OBS. This is our OBS studio here. Go over to OBS. You can see how it looks like here, and click on this add button here. Click on this add button, this sources here, this plus sign at the bottom there, it's the add button. That's what I'm talking about. You can see, so that's the add button there. So click on it and go over to NDI source. You can see NDI source here. Click on this NDI source. Okay, so click on the NDI source and let's name this Bible Lua. Or just name it Bible Show. It's okay, Bible Show, and select OK. Can see it's asking us to select source name. I see, just click on this drop down menu, this one right here. Click on this drop down menu, the button there. I see there. So just click on it, click on it and select, you can see Poor PC Bible Show NDI. Just select that and click on OK. See, click on OK and you can see our Bible is displaying here. See, so this is it. So the Bible is displaying, and if we want to change it from lower third to maybe big screen, still OK, everything will still work fine. You can see, want to return it back to lower third, you can still do that as well. You can see, that's it here. You can see, so this is how it looks like. You see, and this doesn't consume your system CPU or makes more of your system CPU resources. See, everything works perfectly fine, and you can actually use this to display your Bible on OBS in lower third format. Okay, so this is how everything looks like. I'm bringing your camera, your scripture, whichever one you want to do. So I'm just go over to experiment here and go over to video cap and select video capture device. Now let's name this webcam. Let's take, for instance, this is the preacher webcam. Okay, and select integrated webcam, select okay. That's it. This is how it looks like. Just drag it down. I see how everything looks like. So let her not be as one dead, of whom the flesh is half consumed, when he cometh out of his mother's womb. You can see how it looks like. So you can put it on full screen and you can put it on lower third, and this is how to display your scripture in lower third format on OBS. In case you love this video, consider subscribing to this YouTube channel. We are hoping to get to 3,000 family members here on YouTube. Okay, so we are currently at 2,600. All you have to do is subscribe and turn on the notification bell so you always be notified whenever I upload new videos. Okay.